usually has a lot of energy, especially on a Saturday. Good evening, everyone. Excellency Ambassador of Israel to Rwanda, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it's truly an honor and pleasure for me to be here with you this evening, and I want to thank the team from Mashariki African Film Festival for inviting me and giving me the opportunity to be part of the opening ceremony. I must admit it's my first time coming for this, and I was still, by the time I walked in here, I still couldn't tell the difference between Mashariki and Mashirika, and I had to be told what the difference is, but it's still an honor and pleasure that I'm able to be here with you, to be with the local industry that has really been instrumental in growing the filming and creative industry. And just looking at the short video that we watched a few minutes ago that shows the evolution of the filming industry in Rwanda, but also in the East African region, one can only say that the potential is real, and there is so many opportunities going forward to really build a very strong and vibrant industry. I was quickly looking through the statistics, and I think for most of you that are in the audience this evening, you'll agree with me that the filming industry is one that has a high potential of creating decent jobs. And beyond just decent jobs, it's also an opportunity for us as Africa, as East Africa, as Rwanda, to really tell our story from the eyes of people that have been part of that story. No other person would be in a better position to tell our stories. And so it's truly important to see, but also it's also a privilege to really be part of this industry and see the opportunity to tell these stories, to tell a different narrative, but also to grow the economy through the creation of decent jobs. Now, when I got invited to join you this evening, I like to say that with technology, we are very cross-cutting. We find us in healthcare, in education, in agriculture, and now here we are in filming and the creative industry. But also you'll agree with me that the filming and creative industry globally has been one that one has been heavily disrupted by emerging technologies when you talk about AR, VR, IoT, 3D printing. But at the same time, it's the one industry where there's enormous opportunities on how we can really transform the filming industry and how we can transform the user experience, the user engagement when we are telling our stories in a unique way. So my pledge and my call to all of you this evening is how do we create that synergy between emerging technologies to be able to deliver a better user experience, to be able to deliver a better user engagement, but also to be able to expand how we can tell our stories, but also the reach of the people that can hear the stories that we continue to tell through the film industry. And while today we won't be going through all the challenges that the filming industry continues to face globally, whether it's the incentives that are needed to grow the industry, whether it's intellectual property, which is really at the heart of some of the issues that we continue to face as the industry, I think tonight is one where we're here to celebrate the talent that we have within the country, to celebrate the talent that we have within Africa, but also to congratulate those that have made it for this competition and to wish everyone the very best as we go through this week and towards the culmination of the closing ceremony where the awarding will be happening. But I think what's important to know is it's not just a competition, but it's also an opportunity to highlight the talent that we have. It's also an opportunity to figure out how best can we continue to support the local filming industry as a government, but also how can we continue to grow this local filming industry beyond just Rwanda. Because with the title of the organizers, this is beyond Rwanda. It looks at the entire East African community, it looks at the whole of Africa, and I cannot be pledge our support as a collective government to continue to find ways how we can grow and nurture and support the different talent that we have here today. So I won't stay long here, because I know there's more exciting things for all of us to follow this evening, and I thank you for your kind attention.
A big round of applause one more time for the Honorable Minister of ICT, Pona Ingabire. Thank you so much for being with us. Now, ladies and gentlemen, a few things are going to happen now, but this is very exciting. We're going to watch a few trailers. We have